perfect person standing by to talk about what the president discussed, from everything from Venezuela to Afghanistan to what's happening with the coronavirus. He's been leading the charge and sounding the alarm, Senator Tom Cotton of Arkansas. Senator, the president brought it up. He's concerned about the markets, but he says we're in a good place right now and close to a vaccine. What can you tell us?
Good morning, guys. Great to be on with you. I want to commend the president's decisive action last month for shutting down travel from China. About 20,000 passengers a day were coming to the United States from mainland China. So that bought us several weeks to try to get our hands around the coronavirus problem. I'm optimistic about a vaccine, as the president is, in a much faster time frame than you've heard from some experts, you know, 12 to 18 months. I think we can do it much faster than that. What we really need to focus on right now, though, what can be a big difference in a matter of days or weeks, is testing kits and testing criteria. I think we need to expand that testing criteria, and the FDA needs to move faster to get testing kits approved out on the front lines. Right now, unfortunately, we've had fewer than 500 people administered this test in America. The simplest way to stop this outbreak from happening is to test aggressively so we can identify any possible cases. That's where I think our immediate focus needs to be.
The president said out of all the Americans that have come back that were fully quarantined, we're only down to about 10. Most of the Americans are out of danger. He said that he is earmarking $2.5 billion to work on a vaccine. And I know that you all returned this morning, the senators returned this morning. You're getting a classified briefing on this morning. Can you tell us more about it and why it's classified?
Yeah, just in a matter of moments, we'll be stepping into a briefing with administration officials to discuss some of these very topics. So I think the president is right that all the known cases in the United States are quarantined and they're being monitored by health officials. What worries me is possible unknown cases. I mean, take, for instance, in New York City, you had 1,500 people fly directly into New York from Wuhan itself in the month of January before we shut down air travel from China. That's one reason why I think it's so important that we have an aggressive posture towards testing criteria and approving testing kits. Right. That's one thing I'll be discussing in this classified setting. We'll also obviously want to discuss what is happening inside of China, because the Chinese Communist Party is still lying about what's happening in China. They are more concerned about censoring criticism than they are responding to criticism.
Real quick, Senator, one of the other topics was the president was asked about his criticism that Sotomayor and Ruth Bader Ginsburg on the Supreme Court should recuse themselves because of past things. For instance, RBG said during the campaign, and yesterday Sotomayor's scathing dissent about the administration regarding public charges. What do you think about that?
Yeah, those questions, just like Justice Sotomayor's dissent, is an example of liberal Democrats projecting their own behavior onto the president. Justice Sotomayor is complaining that the Supreme Court has now enjoined multiple left-wing judges at the trial court level for blocking the president's entire regulatory reform agenda. What's unprecedented is not what the Supreme Court is doing, it's what all of these resistance judges are doing around the country when the president is passing regulations and they are trying to stop them nationwide from going into effect. That's a practice that has to stop. I'm glad the Supreme Court has been stopping it on an ad hoc basis. They need to stop it permanently.
Senator, you're going to get a classified briefing. We just got the word, so you can go, and we'll have to take a timeout. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Senator.
Thank y'all.